Hi, welcome to another episode of Sip and Sync with Azure. My name is Katie. I'm a global black belt here at Microsoft, and I'm here with Krystal. Krystal, what can you tell me about yourself?
Hey, I'm Krystal Folkes. I'm also a software GBB at Microsoft, and I connect Microsoft and Azure products together with GitHub. And so I'm excited to share a little bit about what we've been working with, some cool ideas on how to enhance your Azure agentic develop experience.
Krystal, that sounds amazing. I know most companies are getting into the ground floor of using agentic workflows, and to combine that with DevOps seems like it might be magic. What can you tell us about what you're going to show today?
Yes, exactly. So I'm going to talk a little bit about agentic DevOps, and this is where we're using agents to really power the software development lifecycle through workflows. And so we're connecting that with Azure AI Foundry agents to be able to connect to the GitHub platform to be able to leverage both of those two to actually automate your workflows.
Oh my goodness, this sounds like a really cool process. What do you hope companies get out of this? What have you seen that has been helpful?
Yeah, so this is the early stages of how we can start rethinking how agentic DevOps can actually work with our ecosystems and being able to transform that. And so we're thinking about how we take GitHub Copilot to the next step, where we can leverage the resources of GitHub Copilot plus DevOps, and thinking of those workflows and reimagining them how with customers on how to make that more transformational across multiple products. So we're excited to show a little bit of example of that today.
Great. Can you show us what you got?
Yeah, so I'll first start by showing the different agent and how the agent is built in AI Foundry and the components of that before we jump in. So there's a 6 steps that we actually go through to actually create this agent within the AI Foundry service. First, we're going to focus on creating a security agent for this example. We're going to use a custom instruction, which I use MCP tools to fetch a security advisory from GitHub Advanced Security, and then focus on the vulnerabilities so that customers can pretend that they were getting insights directly from their GAS service. So we're going to connect through certain MCP tools, which is the GitHub Remote MCP Server tools. I'm doing list global advisories, get global advisory security, list repositories, security advisories, and search repositories. So with these different tools, we're able to actually pull in specific insights directly from the MCP connection. So that's really cool.
Yeah, it seems like there's a lot going on, but it seems like it's really going to help companies, and I really like how all the security built in.
Yeah, so while we continue to focus on that, the agent will create a thread where we'll actually get that message and combine that with the MCP to actually give a response. And so just like similar to working in different agents within AI Foundry, getting that right response is really the key critical thing. So here's an example of how I want the message to actually come back here. We're just going to list the tool to be able to get those critical advisories here. And then our end results would be our agent message. So we'll basically run that and create that message back to the user. So I'm going to show a little bit about how that code works today in action. So within VS Code here, we have a Python application that I created just to be able to do this. So we're using the SDK to be able to connect to the Azure AI project client to be able to pull that in. So once we have all the agent models, we can pull in the ability to do MCP connection within the AI Foundry agent. With that, we'll actually see the MCP server. So you'll see here that we're going to connect to the GitHub MCP server here, and then as well as label that as GitHub. So that's how we're going to connect to the MCP, and you can connect to any MCP. So it's really cool where, yes, we're doing example directly to GitHub, but we're really just trying to leverage MCP as tools within our platform to help extend and bring in that information as needed to the prompts.
Great. And I have a question. How did you decide how to create the prompts? Did you have any tooling to help you, or did you just know the process well enough? Can you explain to me a little bit about that?
Yeah, I actually use GitHub Copilot to show a little bit of how the prompts, right? So my day job is not usually as a in the Azure AI Foundry, but helping customers understand how to actually create those prompts, GitHub Copilot is really great in doing that. So you can actually leverage the chat mode to be able to do that. So to be able to help fine tune that prompt so that you can help iterate through that process as you work through to get the right response for using models.
Great.
Yeah, so let's keep going. We have a couple of projects here where we initialize the MCP tool, And so we're actually specifying options for different allowed tools here in the code. I do have specific tools that I have sent in as security tool lists. So just as I mentioned how we built those tools, I'm actually adding those specific security tools into the platform and specifying. The GitHub MCP remote server does have a list of different tools across the platform that you can use leverage, but because I want to make my agent more tailored and focused for specifically security, we're gonna focus on the security tools, and I just took a subset, right? You could allow all these tools at once, but to be able to get more rich context for your agent to have to make the decision, we wanna have it to reason over a set of tools versus every tool that the MCP server has.
So how do you get access to the GitHub MCP server? Is it built in with your license or how does that work?
Yeah, so the remote MCP server is, you could do it locally or remote or hosted. So there's multiple options on how to do that. Right now I'm connecting through the remote one where I use my authorization through my GitHub pat token to be able to actually connect to that. And then I'm doing that handshake and saying that my application is able to talk to it. Yeah, that's a great question. And so while I go through that, we're working through adding the tools. So I have something that checks for the tools here. And then I'm passing in my token, as you can see here with my code, where I'm able to actually pass in the authored token to validate that my app can talk to, my AI Foundry can talk to GitHub to get the information. So these are my, once you get there, you'll create an agent. Basically, we'll create that pool tool and run that agent in a thread. And then from there, it will create the deployment for AI Foundry to create that project within AI Foundry, within the agent path. And then from there, it basically will set my instructions. So these are my instructions here. You can see that I set the instructions so that the tools are able to actually get what I want and insights. So this is where I had Copilot help me figure out the right instructions to kind of tailor the message on exactly what I wanted. So that's a really cool way of leveraging Copilot, even if you're not as knowledgeable in AI Foundry, how can I accomplish something by having it help me write with the prompt and using that as a starting point to start tuning as we go along within our development. So like it creates an ID and we'll create a thread and then also says that message. And so you can see here, this is the kind of message that it's gonna take from here and it's going to get me results of the two top advisories from the Get Global security agent, and that's what is returning back to me. So this is just an example of showing how to get the information and connecting to the GitHub MCP, but it's a really opening the ways of how we can eventually make specific agents for not only security, but doing planning, doing documentation, being able to answer questions, and bringing that to other connected agents through business, right? So that's really powerful because being able to get answers and insights and reasoning in other platforms and putting that in applications is really what customers really wanted to see.
Right. And so you can take those advisories maybe and then decide what actions you want to take on them.
Exactly. And so that can help lead to more discussions and identify how best ways to kind of improve the team, as well as making sure that they're running a secure firm. So once it creates those messages, it actually will use the MCP tools and actually run through and create that queue. And then this is kind of one way to validate the tools are all working and I was able to connect them. And then as well as that's pretty much the end of the code. It will basically use the tools and close it out and stop the thread. So that is pretty much the code. So I'm actually going to run it here. So we'll actually just going to do a sure here. So we'll run the code here and we'll be able to see the MCP tool actually grab the tools. So I have a bunch of tools enabled here and it actually is going to create that thread and try to create that message. And you can see here it's in progress and running. And then once it's done, it's actually going to throw back at us the actual advisories directly from GitHub, which is really cool.
And you can run this all from your local machine.
Yeah, so this is running directly from my local machine, securely connecting to my GitHub because of that authorization token that we enabled for the application. And there's another way that you could also enable that is you could also connect, making sure that you have managed identity to be able to do that and manage the connection between your AI Foundry and GitHub using Azure Key Vault if that was something that you will want to do for the handshake as well.
Yeah, I know we always recommend managed identity with, you know, if that's possible, it's a really great feature.
Yeah. And so here you'll see this is actually the actual insights. So you can see that it was able to give me the summary table of the advisories here from GAS, and also actually gave me any of the vulnerabilities, and actually pulled directly from GitHub that it's connected to, which is our top advisory. So you can see that this is actually agent that's pulling directly from GitHub and then also formulating that message based on this agent model. And so now we can use this agent across multiple integrations on our systems and platforms. So then you can see how it's going to take any lessons from developers and how to actually solve that. So in real time, you can bring access to information about GitHub without having to go into a developer portal, which is really cool, or go into github.com. And you can apply this to other MCPs as well.
And this is just one agent that does this, right? But could you imagine connecting this with multiple agents?
Yeah, exactly. So you could use this to kind of do multi-agent orchestration between, you know, we're talking about security today, but it could be a documentation agent. You can be a planning agent. It could be multiple different agents for you to really understand how to really orchestrate different flows for your software development lifecycle. So that is really what I want to share today and really show you the power of how the agents. I'll show you one cool thing. Today we have the experience to actually see that agent. So you can see here that the security agent is created, and you can see that with the agent tool. And you're able to actually click on this and see that it's added as an MCP within AI Foundry. So as soon as you do this via code, then you're able to actually see the MCP tool added as an agent. And so for now, you have to do it through the SDK, but it is works to be able to come out very soon. So we're excited to have that.
Krystal, this was amazing. I know for me, to see this in action, to see you running it locally, it is so cool. And it looks like you spent some time doing it, but it can be used. It opens to me the possibilities of what you can do to improve your DevOps process. I mean, it's really limitless, and this is just the start, I guess. Huh?
Yeah, we're really trying to reimagine the agentic DevOps experience across not only just GitHub Copilot and GitHub, but really showing the better together experience between Microsoft Azure and your software cycle. So it's really amazing where we're going. And that's kind of the experience we really want to transform organizations to be frontier on, how to actually move together in an agentic way across platforms. So happy to be here, and thank you.
Oh, thank you. It kind of, we're the together story. I'm the Azure side and you're the DevOps side.
Yeah.
So. Well, again, I want to thank you for an amazing demonstration, and hopefully I'll see you all soon. Thank you for coming to Azure Simple Sake. And if you have any comments, I know that Krystal and I would love to hear, to see what everybody thinks of this and what questions you might have. So you can look at the comments below, feel free to leave them. And we're going to have some links and other resources. So please come back. And, you know, if you like it, if you like what you're seeing, please follow this channel. Thank you.